Hello, and welcome to part 3 of Zestopia. So where we left off last time, we just finished our motorway kind of expansion creation. So we now have two junctions which allow the city to connect to the outside world. And now we're going to address the problem that as we were building that, there was a great demand for industrial and residential housing. So that's what we're going to do. So first of all, we're going to convert this area into a cul-de-sac district. It is quite cool how now they have kind of random debris sort of lying around it. It kind of adds a little bit to the game, doesn't it? So I'm going to do that. This little area here, shall we... let's extend this one down there. So if we do that, then before we put our zoning down, let's create a few paths. Just to make sure, because this, I mean, this will help a lot when we start integrating transport into the city. Means people can get to bus stations and such a lot quicker. Let's water the area. There's that little tiny offshoot there. Let's pause the game for a second just while I zone. That way we don't get houses that try and build on smaller tiles while we're still painting the zones. There we go. That's one area of residential. This one doesn't have water, does it? No. Let's build some water down here. Okay. Yeah, because look, all these need workers. Not enough educated workers. Okay. Yeah, we should address this, shouldn't we? But we haven't got the money. When's our next... when is our next milestone for population? I thought it told you. Oh, here it is. 4,200. Okay. We'll just have to create a few residential zones for now. But next priority is to build a school. Let's extend this road down here a little bit. And create a district in this area. For residential. Residential? For industrial, sorry. Don't think you'd want to live here. Okay, so... I'm making the effort... obviously, I won't put cul-de-sacs in an industrial area because... It's going to be quite a lot of lorries and things, and that's going to require larger roads. Let's come down to where we end the dual carriageway there. And then in here. Let's create this efficiently. Why will it not let me do that? Why can't I use that one? Come on. Alright then. There we go. And we'll have a offshoot here. We'll create a path. Like that. What else does the industrial zone need? I would like to create a park as well. Just to make sure that we're not... We're doing what we can to alleviate some of the polluted areas. Just so it's not a wasteland, really. That's a huge park, isn't it? Let's try something a bit smaller. Let's put it there. And then, pause, can I use this instead? Right. And then water the area. Water availability is doing okay at the moment. Better check on power as well, because I know we had a little bit of an issue last episode with that. Oh, no, it's great, because we built that. So what we should actually do is lower the budget for the power. Let's just unpause the game. We lower it to 90%. Is that going to affect things? Maybe a little bit more. 85. This means we can have a bit more money rolling in. Obviously, taxes are going to help as well from the buildings that will be constructed here. Look at that huge boulder. That is a nice boulder. Okay, so our residential... Let's see how it's going on. Is that crime? Nope, it's rubbish. So we could do with building a recycling centre. Let's build it there. Yeah, look, there's a lot of recycling that needs to be done. Let's put one there. I want to try and avoid using landfills if possible. It's not the nicest thing for our residents to look at. There we go, the underpass is connecting the residential area quite nicely. That's good. Let's just, while this is building, let's just check how things are going. So traffic, yeah, I kind of suspected that that might be a tiny concern for traffic, and that is what it is, a tiny concern. This area here seems to be doing okay, don't have much congestion, but that is obviously because we are still a new city. So congestion's not really going to come into play until we get, say, about 5,000 population. Then we'll see the effects. Zoning's doing great. I want to make a small commercial district here, which we shall do. So let's make sure the last little bit's watered and create a commercial area. There we go. Okay, so health-wise, everyone's doing good. Fire safety-wise, this area is not doing the best, but something we can come on to. Everyone's okay police-wise. Education, again, yeah. We need a high school. That is our next step. 24,000. Debating whether we should take out a loan, because it's going to solve this problem here, because these buildings are closing down. Can we take a loan out? Small loan, 20,000. If only I could have a small loan of $1 million, you know. That's what we need. Better school. That's elementary. Elementary, my dear Watson. Oh man, that's a big school. Okay. Yeah, somewhere around here would be perfect, wouldn't it? Let's try and facilitate this. Okay. Actually, here would be a good shot, wouldn't it? If we can create... That's actually on an angle. Never mind. I want to try and create a 90 degree... Yeah, there we go. We can nestle the school here. Will that affect everyone? Way! Okay. That was an important step. I think that was worth the loan, to be honest. Look at that hedge! Woohoo! Let's build the... let's build past that kind of mound there. So we now have a high school. That should help things. Had to take out a loan for it, but you know, we've got to do these things. We've got to make sure the city's going to thrive and that our citizens are happy. Everything seems to be going okay. This has had a small number of visitors. I do like the UK editions of things. You've even got Betfred logos. It's pretty, if anyone's ever kind of seen football, Betfred's quite synonymous with that. But it is quite good. I love how City Skylines incorporates the modding community. It's so much better than SimCity. So, I mean, this obviously, me being British, I understand that games are made with an American setting. That's fair enough. But it's great that I can just download mods which basically just make the game feel British to me. It's a good step forward for city builders. Tons of pubs and shops is what we want to see. Okay, so residential is still in demand, isn't it? How should we go about... I kind of feel like we should maybe buy this square. In fact, that is what I'm going to do. 5,300. It's going to consume a lot of money. But I'd like to... I don't want to expand this way. I want to safeguard this land for now. Fire! Oh no. Domino's is on fire! Them pizzas are too hot. Go on, son. Cheers, mate. Right. So... residential wise, so how are we going to build this next section? Let's create a road through here. The reason I've chosen this side, like I said, obviously this is going to be safeguarded for high density, but we have quite a few buildings like the schools and things which would benefit from having residential zones at this side. From what we'll do is adjoin this path to the main road. And people can build there if they want to. That's fine. And then what we'll do is we'll have this road here come across to here. And I'm going to start building this with traffic in mind. So, do you know what I'm going to do? I'm going to create a roundabout. Now, this may be an alien concept to a lot of you Americans watching. But it does very well for traffic. So all I have to do is just create a circle, remove the inner roads. In fact, actually, I'm going to put the roads on first, like this. It doesn't kind of contort the roundabout then. Otherwise, it doesn't really become, it doesn't retain its circularity. It becomes more of an oblong. Okay. So then, we have this area here, so we'll build a cul-de-sac. If we do that, will that join onto the path? Yes, perfect. Cool, so that's a cul-de-sac. And we'll join that to there. And maybe one down here as well. Water the area. It's quite a lot of people pick up on the fact that the designs that I kind of do in quite a few of the games aren't really the most economical ways to build. And that's true. So here it could be very easy for me to kind of go, yep, line, 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 and do grid designs as you would find in American in America. But I don't know. I just have a soft spot for designing in a European fashion. I just believe that it makes the game a bit more realistic, and it imposes its it imposes a set of challenges as well. I know it might be making the game a little bit more difficult, but I'd rather have the game more difficult and have to put up with the challenges that come with making designs like this, which mainly is traffic. So how do you plan where, basically, when your designs are like this, traffic kind of funnels down certain roads that you wouldn't expect. You tend to have to find that you have to expand certain roads, and you know, that's part of the game, isn't it? It's more strategy, and it's a strategy game. Not enough educated workers, 3 out of 5. It's getting better though, isn't it? Let's see how many people are in the high school. Yeah, so it's nearly full, isn't it? So, high school. Oh yeah, so this stays red because they're not actually educated yet, I believe. Yeah, so there's good availability, that's what we need. Modern high school. Then we've got 189 places for universities, and also the power's dropping off, so let's increase our budget. Here we go. That should solve that. Hooray! Educated workers. Well educated. Yes, so we need a university as well. That's going to come more into the terms of a bigger city though, isn't it? So maybe that's on hold for now. What should we do with this plot of land here? Should we make it residential? I wouldn't want to encourage more traffic with a commercial district, so maybe residential is going to be the best shout. Okay. So how can we do this? Let's have a normal road which goes along here and connects back up to there. Yeah, because we don't want it to be too close to the highway, motorway, either, do we? Let's fill this in. It's not going to build at the moment because it probably doesn't have water. Oh no, it does. For the most part. There we go. Let's see if we can create some paths just so it's easier to get around. Not really any point in creating a path there because you can't go over the highway, can you? Do we need a path to the industrial area? We have this bridge, don't we? I mean, we could potentially make a footbridge. In fact, yeah, let's do that because that would actually benefit. So we'll make a footbridge here so the commercial district and this residential area can actually walk to the industrial area should they want to. Oops. There we go. And what we'll also do is put a ton of trees in between the highway and the residential area because it's going to block quite a bit of noise. Doesn't cost too much money to do, but it has quite a lot of benefits in terms of happiness for the citizens. Frantic clicking. There we go. Let's put some here as well. Good stuff. How's everything doing? A few buildings are closing down. Oops. Oh yeah, that's water availability's problem. Let's increase that budget. Was that going to help? Or does it need to be increased further? Nope, that's fine. I'm going to increase it a little bit more, though. So we are teetering on the edge. 90%. Put the power up a tiny bit. Our loan. So we're paying back $400 a week. Okay. But money's slowly picking up, which is good. So how are these doing? Pollution obviously is going to be contained to there, that's fine. Traffic's doing okay. Noise, you see, commercial areas are generating quite a bit of noise, but they don't seem to be too bothered in the residential districts. Fire's a bit of a problem over there, that's fair enough. Death care isn't available to us yet, but healthcare is, and that's looking alright. If we were to build another clinic, it'll be in this area down here. Education. Universities, obviously, yeah, so 225. We've got a lot of university students cropping up. I'm sure a university costs quite a bit, though. Yeah, 45,000, 60,000. Yeah, that's definitely going to be on hold for a bit, isn't it? Okay. We do have buses as well, but buses are going to contribute quite a lot to our budget. I don't really want to go down that route just yet. Buses are going to come important when there's quite a bit of traffic, and we're not in that position at the moment. Let's create here another residential district. So we curve this road around. So just for future development, we'll go down there, and then we'll have a road which attaches down here. Should we have another road that goes across there? I don't think we should need to. Let's just create cul-de-sacs from this one. We'll have one around here. And then we'll have one over here as well. If I do it where I've just placed it there, it creates another zebra crossing, you see. And then we'll path this up. I'd like to create a path over here. Let's demolish this house. Right, because then, look, if I create a sidewalk, oh man, if I create a zebra crossing there, that'll do. Yeah, they can basically walk to the commercial zone from there. If I water this, this should be the last residential area we'd have to build for quite some time, because the demand's quite low. Do that, and call it the rest. Whoops. Here we go. So that should be fine, residential-wise. Are our parks doing okay? Yeah, everyone's happy with parks. That's good. It's very good. Industrial. So this is building quite well, but it needs workers, which is fair enough. We've just built a residential sector, so maybe we should add a tiny bit onto our industrial sector. Oh, we can build this way now as well. How should we do this? Maybe. In fact, what we're going to do is extend this dual carriageway around. If I can build it there first. We do this. Don't like that curve. That's better. And then what we'll do is have this one go down here. We'll create a side on there. So by doing that, you see, just again, it alleviates a bit of traffic. I'm sure I have some really thin parks that I could use along here. Is that it? Do that. Just like a side, like a boardwalk kind of thing. Then I'll add a few trees down here. Again, it's just when I'm building the industrial areas, I just want to take into account that the pollution ain't going to be good. So any parks we can contribute to the area is going to help the land value and the happiness of the citizens around it. So you see, that looks a little bit nicer. And as it goes down here, where does it eventually need to go to? So we could have the long-term plan of this road to come out here. Okay, that looks like the best idea. In fact, we could make that now if we really wanted to. How much would it cost? 7,000. It's not really worth it. But we'll extend it to there for now. And we'll have a road which comes from here. I get very picky with my corners, as you may have guessed. Brilliant. Okay, I'm happy with that. Right, then we can extend this road along here and have it connect to there. And have another road along here. And one more in there. There we go, perfect. And then we'll add a quick path. Water the area. Oops, a tiny little bit there needs doing. Pause the game for a second. So whilst we do this. And that should be plenty for now. I mean, we don't want to build any zone quicker than the other zones for the reasons that we've just seen. There'll be no workers or anything. So we want to make sure that we're kept. Oh, that's 10,000. I'm going to hold off building one of those. Yeah, we'll come on to that bit later. But at least we have the industrial area in place. And eventually when traffic becomes an issue, we have a back-out clause. We can just build this road to the highway and we're done. We're sorted. Because I'm very cautious that with junctions, you tend to find that all your traffic will bottleneck to these junctions. So it's good to keep an eye out just as to when that becomes an issue for the citizens. So like there. See, that's not really queuing traffic, so that's all right. Though what we can do, you see, to alleviate congestion here, is turn off the traffic lights, because there's no point in waiting there when they're pretty much just going to go that way anyway. Yeah, so that's actually going to help congestion a lot. Just that's why Traffic Manager is such a good mod in itself, the fact that you can make those decisions which you wouldn't normally be able to make, and without building anything we've just helped traffic quite substantially. When that actually goes down, you'll see how much it's helped. So it's good to have mods like that available. And again, that's only possible by the modding community. So shout out to both the modding community and the creators of the game for facilitating it. Right, so everything's kind of stable at the moment. Plus 5,000 coming in. There's a fire in there. Oh no, it's quite far away from the fire station, isn't it? Oh no, it's not too far. Where's the truck? Come on, where's the fire truck? It's there. Hurry! Go! Why? Go! I hope it gets there in time. I'm going to feel really guilty if it doesn't. Oh, no! I'm so protective over my citizens. It's unreal. Okay, so this is slowly building up. This poor sod who's built his house in the middle of nowhere. It's like how this is how Up started, isn't it? The movie. Right, so. See, at this point, it's like everything's slowly building. There's not really any need for any major changes or expansion. We'll build a few more residential and we'll build a bit of everything. So we have an industrial zone. That's fine. Residential's there. Commercial's really the only thing we need, isn't it, at the moment? So let's do this. Let's take this road and connect it down here. This is as far as I'm building commercial wise in this direction. So we can have a small area here, can't we? What we'll do is create this and then have the middle part as footpaths. There we go. And then we'll just fill that with trees as well. It's not really a park, but in, you know, a real-world scenario, it would pretty much be classed as one. It's a shame you can't kind of drag and zone parks. That would be quite handy. But it would make sense behind the school, you know, no noise and keeping them away from, you know, keeping the high school students away from society. Okay. Water down there. So we have a commercial area for buildings, so that's fine. Every single zone at the moment has an area for itself to expand, which is what we want. And we're starting a to get a small road network as well now. So we have this dual carriageway, which seems like it's going to become quite important for the area. We have a major road around here. So you see how the roads are sort of developing as we go, and it's, you'll see that some roads are going to be expanded and we'll have sort of key routes as traffic becomes quite an issue in the city. How is traffic doing? Good is the answer. As is education. Again, university is going to be a bit much. How far are we? We see we're quite close to being a bigger town. What do we get then? Oh, so we get nicer roads. Police, hospital. Okay. Let's try and encourage some residential building. In fact, what we could do in this area is create a small retail park. Because it's quite far from the other sort of leisure area we have, which is this football field. So what we'll do is we'll create a retail park, which may be a... Well, it's, I was going to say it may be a new concept to Americans, but it isn't. Because in America, all you really have are retail parks. Maybe I'm using terminology that's not kind of used over there. But a retail park is basically just a collection of shops and a car park. To be quite unspecific. What's that? Public pool. Okay. Can't remember downloading that, but that's fine. So we've got 2x4 car park. Okay. This is how we'll do it. We'll do a small retail park. So we'll have a road that comes up here. Two-way road. I'm sure there was a concrete road like that. Two-lane road with grass. Two-lane road. Okay, we'll just have to use this. And 1, 2, 3, 4. So if we put a road there, and what we can do is create some car park. Oh, bugger. The only problem with these car parks is it creates a swarm of seagulls above them. Is that realistic? I mean, you could probably argue it is, but yeah. It's not really what you want, is it? That's a big tree. It's also a big tree. That's a bigger tree. Oh, man. There we go. That'll do. No, it won't. Oh, shrubs. Yes. Let's just line this footpath. It's these details which make a city, definitely. Come on. There we are. So we have a footpath through the car park. Let's see if we can add a crosswalk. Yes, perfect position. Right. And then what we can do is come to our unique buildings. Hopefully this doesn't cost a lot. It costs a little bit. Let's build an Asda, which is our British version of Walmart. And we can build a park there as well. So we have a shopping centre. Well, shopping centre, a supermarket. It's not really a centre, is it? So we can do that, and then what we can do here is create another crosswalk. Add a footpath. Create a few trees. There we go. Now we can create some residential area around this as well. what we can do is we'll have this road come down here and connect onto there. And then we'll create a small cul-de-sac here. See, the problem in the UK is we don't have many of these footpaths, so a lot of these cul-de-sacs are kind of just left without good access to anything else. It's a bit difficult. Here we go. More to that last little section. And there we go. We have a supermarket with a car park, which does actually get used, which is surprising. So people will actually park here and then go into the Asda. So, with the time being what it is, I would say that's all we should do for this part. So, when we started, we had an issue where there was a big demand for housing, and we had a commercial sector which was needing more educated workers. We seem to have solved that. The commercial sector seems very happy. Zoning seems to be good. Had small demand for residential, which is what you need, because obviously these need workers. So that's fine, that's going well. And we've expanded the city ever so slightly, so we're creeping towards the point where we're able to actually build high density buildings and create obviously larger cities. So that's been part 3. Thank you very much for watching, and I hope to see you again in the next part.